Hello, this video is a little bit more scientific than usual. By showing you a couple of testing methods, John's going to talk you through how to take your soil pH level at home. This is a great indicator of the sort of plants that will grow best in your garden. The rhododendron plants from last week's video on frost damage are still being used as an example, so let's see how we get on. Hello, welcome to John Horsey Horticulture. John's been teaching horticulture professionally for over 30 years now, and on this channel we're hoping to help you develop your gardening skills. Whether you're new to gardening, looking for some basic foundations on propagation techniques, growing some vegetables, a bit of pest control, or whether you're a seasoned horti who could always do with some new tips and advice. If you like learning those things, do consider following us. There's no charge, just push the subscribe button. If you push the all-important notification bell, that lets you know every time we upload a new video.
Hello again. We are here still with our rhododendrons, and we've talked about how they have to look out, we have to be aware of the weather. But the other thing we need to be aware of, and you've probably heard about this, is that rhododendrons like a low soil pH. Now, there's a lot of mystery in this, but pH, literally, it means potential hydrogen. But it is a scale of the acidity and alkalinity of your soil. The full pH scale runs from about from 0 to 14, with 7 being neutral. In a garden, we're very unlikely to go down below 4, and that would only be on acid heathland, or above maybe 8, possibly 9 if you're on the chalk downland. The problem is that rhododendrons have a job taking up certain nutrients, especially iron, when they're on an alkaline soil. So what we have to do is just to check that we don't have an alkaline soil. If you look at this chart, the iron's along here, you see, and when you've got low pH, it's readily available. When you get up here to neutral, it starts to be less available. You get to 7, it's coming down quite dramatically. And that is why rhododendrons, sometimes people will put what they call chelated iron in if they haven't got the right pH. It's all to do with the rhododendrons being able to take up iron from the soil. And that chart, I think, shows you why they can't take it up when it gets to neutral. Okay, so it's a little bit of science today to explain what it's all about. And I've done this chart here, which I give to all my students, and it's how the pH scale works. And you can see 4, as I said, that's very acid, and it has ericaceous lime-hating plants in things like heathers, azaleas, rhododendrons and conifers. The other extreme is 9, where you've got the calcic holes, being things which love the alkaline, and that's the clematis and the viburnums. The neutral is 7, and the ideal, if you can, the best pH you can get, if possible, is 6.5. Now, if you have a job remembering this, I've got a little trick. If you want to think whether 4 is acid or alkaline, you just remember how many letters there are in acid. And it's 4. Very convenient. And even better, if you come over this way, how many letters in alkaline for 8 is 8. And 7 is even neutral, so it's a really very handy way of remembering it. Now, you're going to say to me, why does it matter? Well, the reason it matters is because the nutrients which plants need are available at different pHs. And you're probably aware of the plant nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, NPK, they're the common ones. But also things like calcium, magnesium, iron and manganese, they're all important to plants. This chart shows you how available they are at certain pHs. So if you look at 4, that's down there, a lot of them, in fact nitrogen, is not even available at 4. They're going right down. They are also going down at this end. So if you run a line through the, shall we say, the widest parts, it is 6 here, about 6.5. Then you've got lots of nitrogen, you've just got the phosphorus coming in there, potassium, calcium, magnesium, iron, and manganese. So that's why it's important to know where you are. Now, of course, a lot of situations you've got, you know, you'll just have to live with what you've got. You may find that your soil is very alkaline, you won't be able to grow rhododendrons, or you grow them in containers. But here we know that our soil is about neutral. The reason I know that, because in the garden already we have some lovely rhododendrons. There's one behind us there, which is full of bud and it's going to be absolutely beautiful. But I did put one in that my children gave me, and it's not looking awfully well, so I think that might need a bit of help later on. So you're going to say, now, how do we work out what the pH scale is? Well, there are simple tests, and you can get these pH tests, and really it's all to do with reading off of a chart. This one just shows you what you have to do. Well, first of all, you fill your tube up to the mark, as it says, and this has just got a little bit of soil in it. No leaves, no stones, just the mineral part of the soil. Then you add a scoop of what we call barium sulfate. The barium sulfate settles the indicator solution. So we just have to get a little bit of it in a little teeny little spoon here. And you just need one heaped teaspoon, which goes in like that. There we are, that's enough. It's very simple. Then we get the soil testing solution, and we top it up to 2.5. And there's 2.5 I can see there. So just, there we are, it's up to 2.5. Put the lid back on here, give it a good shake, making sure you hold the lid so it doesn't come flying off. And then you have to let it just settle down. Okay, and after a while that will settle down and you'll be able to read off your pH. Now, as they say in all good programs, here's one I prepared earlier, and I've actually got a few here. That is the one, exactly the same sample which was taken earlier, and you can see the colours come out. And what I do is I read off against the chart, and I think in that case it's between pH 6.5 and 7. So it's slightly acid, and it'll be just fine from the rhododendrons. What I would really like is if it were down a bit like that one, which is a really low pH. You can see that's probably 5.5, isn't it? But the one I don't want is this one, which you can see is really up here. That's a very limey one, and that's 7.5. We also have these meters now, which are getting better and better, which you just stick in and they read it. But to be on the safe side, it's always worth doing a chemical test. Right, so let's see how this one works. We know from the chemical that the pH is about 6.5 to 7. So we'll just put it in and see what happens. Oh, that's going down to, it's moving about a bit. That's coming out at 6. Well, that's even better for the rhododendrons. Here we are. Well, see. What I might do is actually take another chemical test and see whether that is a 6 again. Here we are. That's the modern way of doing it.
For joining us. If you're interested in either of those kits, I put the link in the description below. If you'd like to check our courses out, link is in the description below as well. We're offering garden history online this year, which is very exciting. In the meantime, enjoy the rest of your week. Thank you for joining us. Until next time.